So the kittens did not make it then?
No, they didn't. They didn't survive.
You're on.
Oh, hi. Welcome to this very special edition of 420 News. I'm Weijer Wilson. Today is a very special day. It is April 20th, which is also known as Weed Day.
Yes, it is, Weijer.
Well, it's a very, very special day. I'm joined here by my colleague from Colorado, Dr. Cynthia Joint. She's here today to discuss some of both the mental and physical effects weed can have on the human body.
Thanks for having me again. It's nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Alrighty, so many people are aware that marijuana can create a chillax state, as the kids are saying.
Sure.
But there are also many bad effects that it can have on your body, mentally and physically. So, the main ingredient in marijuana is THC, and that can result in brain cell loss, memory damage, and even depression. Also, smoking marijuana can lead to delusion, psychosis, hallucinations, and the loss of balance, which can make things like driving very dangerous. And so people are calling this doped driving. And doped driving impairs your psychomotor skills, divided attention, and cognitive functions. Although drunk driving is still far more dangerous. And on the good side though, marijuana used for medical reasons can slow the progression of cancer, prevent seizures, and treat many eye diseases. Also, it's interesting to note that the marijuana used on the patients is the same kind that you'd see on the streets by the druggies.
Very interesting.
Yes.
So I do have one question.
Yes.
That's very interesting. A lot of information in there. In your expert opinion, Dr. Joint, would you say marijuana is more good or more bad?
Well, I think that's really up to the viewers, you know?
That's a very, very good point. Very good point. It's up to you guys. Now let's take it on to our little crash course weed history with John Green.
Hello, or should I say hi? I'm John Green, and welcome to Crash Course Weed History. Let's go back to the beginning of green. Starting in the early 1900s, Mexican immigrants introduced us to the chillest of leaves. Some weeds are considered nuisances to farmers and mothers alike, but this one was loved across America. Many sad stereotypes came across initially, connecting the Mexicans to this happy leaf. But then, soon enough, it was coming across the border in truckloads. This, of course, led to higher federal regulations on the border and negative publicity towards weed. A single court case in California where a man was accused of manslaughter while driving intoxicated by the drug led to people believing that this was a gateway for the devil into the soul. And it got national attention, and so was the drug tied to it. As years went on, people continued to use marijuana for personal and medical use. During the Great Depression, it became feared and was outlawed in 29 states by 1931. Each state, one by one, began to outlaw the use of the drug until 1937, when the Marijuana Tax Act was published, limiting the use of the drug across the nation. Of course, this did not completely make it illegal, but it gained profit for the government and a huge tax on the drug to the birth of the Boston Weed Party. This generated some disappointment for potheads and stoners, but temporarily appeased those who thought Satan was literally living inside a weed. Speak of the devil himself, Herbert Hoover made it widely accepted for the use of weed for stress. And as World War II and Roosevelt came along, they had more important things to do. In comes the greatest generation of arrogant elitists. So by the 1960s, marijuana became popular in the upper white class, a poor man's drug taking over society, and with it, the birth of hippies. Hippies were cool, I guess, but it wasn't what they were, it was about the movement that they did to the country. The country became more divided on the issues of weed, and we gained the modern love of weed that we have today. Along the way, hippies gained the name hipsters and become incredibly frustrated when you call them hippies. The modern era gave birth to the edible forms of brownies, cookies, and other chocolatey forms of chemical-based marijuana foods for higher users. In Colorado, Washington, Alaska, and Oregon, they created higher taxes for those items. As more states legalize the use of marijuana, it becomes a huge social issue that is ever-changing and very amusing. Thanks for watching Crash Course Weed History. This is John Green.
Thanks, John. Appreciate that. That was very informative and interesting. We now have a very, very special opportunity to go downtown to the Weed Festival, where Hannah Biss is live reporting on the scene and interviewing street potheads, you could say, about their opinions of weed. Hannah?
Thank you, Weedro. Today I am in downtown at the Marijuana Festival interviewing a young participant named Mary. I'm sorry, how do you pronounce your name?
Juana.
Mary Juana. So, Mary, how do you feel that marijuana has changed and the culture surrounding it since you have entered the cannabis community?
Well, I feel like marijuana just really brings people together. And it all started centuries ago, you know, in the Vietnam War. And it just it really kind of brought people together, because it was like a big f*** you to the government, you know? Like, you can do what you want. You can do what you want. You don't need to listen to anyone. Thank you.
All right, thank you. And Mary, how do you feel that marijuana has personally impacted you and your life?
Hold on. It's your turn to serve, sir. I don't have all day.
Mary.
We all paid to be here.
Mary.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh. Well, this is a very hard question for me to answer, but weed is life.
All right. Thank you, Mary, for your input, and back to you, Weedrow. Ma'am, you don't... No, that's not for...
Thanks, Hannah. We now have a pre-made video for you interviewing random street people about their opinions of marijuana. Let's check that out right now.
Do you think marijuana should be legal in the United States?
Oh, God, no. I think it's awful. It's a drug.
What is your personal opinion about the use of marijuana in the United States?
Ah, man, I think that it is good. I think everybody should personally use it.
What are some of the negative effects of marijuana that you know?
Getting arrested.
Do you think weed makes you cool?
I do think weed makes you cool. It makes you feel good, so I guess feeling good is always being cool.
Yeah. What is your stance on the recreational use of marijuana?
I mean, I think it's wrong. I think it's making kids stupid, and less people are graduating from high school.
Part, Pineapple Express, Reggie.
Ganja, weed, pot, Mary Jane.
Purple Kush, Balls of Fury.
Marijuana, pot, grass. That's all I can think of.
Thank you for joining us for this very special edition of 420 News. For all of us here at the studio, let's blow this joint.
Because I got high, because I got high, because I got high.
Go to the next, go to the next, go to the next.